All right. This is where I have to take a deep breath. Clearly, the message about this being your show is getting through. And in the last week, 25% of your emails have been on one subject, a truly incomprehensible piece of bureaucracy involving a very brave young Marine, 20-year-old Joe Townsend. While serving for our country, fighting in Afghanistan with 40 Commando Royal Marines, he was returning from a patrol and was just yards from the safety of their base when he stepped on a mine. After 12 hours of emergency surgery, he was flown to Selly Oak Hospital in Birmingham, where he spent 5 weeks in critical care. Joe Townsend has lost both his legs. Joe had hoped to start rebuilding his life and gaining his independence by building a disabled access bungalow on land owned by his grandparents near Pevensey in East Sussex. Proposals for the building were submitted to Wealden District Council, who denied permission for the bungalow. Now, you clearly feel passionate about this story, which is why we have now picked it up.
Joe was in Afghanistan for about 6 months before he was injured. He was out on patrol and stepped on an anti-personnel mine. Joe's lost both his legs and he's got other injuries as well. Absolutely devastated, yeah, it's your worst nightmare.
When Joe was in hospital at his really low ebb, we were heartbroken.
We thought it might be a good idea to try and get planning to build him a little bungalow in the paddock.
When his granddad mentioned it, that's what sort of spurred him on to keep going.
So where was the bungalow going to be?
Well, we want to set it, I don't know, 15 feet from the barn, just in that corner.
What was the reasons for turning down the application?
Well, the circumstances in this case, not considered sufficient.
He's a war hero. Oh,
no. I know, the young lad's gone out, been blown apart, and nobody seems to want to help them.
What does Joe have to do to be more exceptional than to serve his country, to lose both of his legs, and just want somewhere to live in peace, to get on with the rest of his life?
He set his heart on this. It got him through the really tough times, you know, when he was so badly. I mean, you go, I can't even do it.
No, yeah.
It's just when you think what he's been through.
I don't know if they understand really what Joe needs. I'm not sure they do understand that.
What was the council's other reason?
Intrusive development within this semi-rural area.
Intrusive development?
Yeah.
Let me get this right. You're not building a block of flats.
No.
You're not building a big mansion house.
No.
You're building a what?
A bungalow.
A bungalow. So this is roughly it, isn't it, what we've marked out here? You're not overlooked at all, are you?
No. The only way you'll see anything is by air.
By air.
Funny you should say that. I've got the helicopter. About 1,000 foot up at the moment, that is the proposed site for Joe's bungalow. The council say that it's an intrusive development, but to be honest with you, who to? You're right next door here, aren't you?
Yeah, no, it's neighbour, yeah.
Yeah, so have you got any objections to them building?
None at all.
On this occasion, just throw the rule book away and speak from the heart.
For all the lad's been through, you know, we think he deserves it.
To date, there's not been one single objection from any neighbours about the proposal.
The planners have been in touch now, and they want to meet next week with a view to coming up with some different plan. They want us, ideally, to add an annex to our house, which is not going to give Joe his independence. I just don't understand where they're coming from.
I spoke to David and Linda's local MP to get some answers. What can you as an MP really seriously do?
I'm going to be lobbying here in the House of Commons to see if the government will actually issue new guidance so that councils like Wealden, however well-intended, don't again, you know, stand in the way of a home fit for heroes. We say that they deserve special treatment. We've actually got to mean it and make sure that gets, you know, recognised in the planning system and that nobody else has to go through these ridiculous hoops that that Joe has gone through.
That's all very well, but actions speak louder than words.
Please let us have it. It's it means so much to Joe.
Debbie, how is Joe?
Joe's fine. He's just getting over surgery that he had yesterday, but he's fine.
Thank you so much for coming on.
It's okay.
You've got a statement from Wealden District Council.
I have, actually. It says the council seeks to support families who need to provide extended care facilities, but the erection of a new bungalow would be intrusive and in direct conflict with existing policies. We have a duty to balance any proposals for new development with the strongly held wishes of the community in Wealden to protect our rural environment. The council has made it clear that they are prepared to negotiate with Joe and his family.
On Facebook at the moment, there's about 140,000 people supporting Joe. There's a 7,000 named petition. We invited the council to come on the show. They declined. Their head of press, Jim Vandenbos, actually said, "We don't talk to entertainment shows like yours." Well, actually, Mr. Vandenbos, I've got a message for you. Don't simply think this is an entertainment show and decide then that you don't want to talk to us. Because Mark Prince and the fight against knife crime didn't just turn around and dismiss us as an entertainment show. Actually, I created this show. I do not get paid a penny to do this show. I decided, no fee, I wanted to put my heart and soul into it because I want to fight people like you and your council, because I think you're at the heart of what is wrong with this country. If actually... And do you know something?
Yes.
And do you know something, Mr. Vandenbos? Mr. Vandenbos and Wealden District Council, I know I'm right. Nick Clegg, he's behind us. David Cameron has given us a statement. And wait for this, Wealden District Council and Mr. Vandenbos, who would sneer at what we're doing here, because you're sneering at millions of other people in this country. Just remember, by the way, you're a public servant. Who pays your money? Just before we came on the air, we contacted the Prime Minister's office. The Prime Minister, Gordon Brown, said, quote, "The whole country owes Joe a huge gratitude for the sacrifice he has made for our country. It is unacceptable that he is being stopped from having the home of his choice. Wealden District Council must do the right thing immediately and reconsider this case," unquote. I make no excuse for talking in such a passionate way. I can't remember feeling this angry, and I've never been this angry in a studio. Wealden District Council, I don't know when the elections are up, but the people of the area hopefully will have their say, and maybe they'll be advertising for a new press officer soon. I want to end this on an up note, because we will get what Joe wants. And in the meantime, I wanted to give you a gift from us to Joe. I know he loves the great outdoors. We did a little bit of research. So I know this is what he would want. It is a state-of-the-art all-terrain wheelchair. It is the latest. It's carbon fibre, aluminium. It's so he can get out and about.
Thank you very much.
Because, Debbie, believe me, we might not always believe in what goes on overseas, but when we stop respecting the ladies and gentlemen of our armed forces, this country really is in a shocking state. See you after the break.